Welcome to the review of the Lego Batman movie set Scarecrow Special Delivery. This is the final part of the three reviews that I've been doing on all the sets that make up the Gotham Power Plant, or Gotham Energy Facility as it is called in the film. Without further ado, let's get started by looking at the minifigures and their details.
Guess what I'm going to say.
This Batman is exactly the same as in the Mr. Freeze Ice Attack set and the Joker's Balloon Escape set. The only difference being with this Batman is that he has two batarangs, not a flamethrower or a grapple gun. I'm not going to talk about the actual figure because that's in the Joker Balloon Escape set. It's not in the Mr. Freeze Ice Attack set because it's in the Joker Balloon Escape set and they are the same Batman, just with different accessories. All I'm going to talk about is the batarangs. They're nicely shaped. They are a common accessory to Batman figures, and I have got lots of them. And they're just a very simple accessory that worked really well with the figure. Although I would like to see something unique with this figure. For example, the grapple gun and the flamethrower are unique for the Mr. Freeze Ice Attack and Joker Balloon Escape set. So I'd like to see a unique accessory for this Batman. But apart from him being the same Batman, apart from him having batarangs, he's the same Batman. So next I will talk about the worker.
Next we are going to look at the worker.
Now the worker comes with plain black legs, a cup of tea, a very simple printed body, two heads which makes them unique. However, I'm not going to be showing the two different heads. I will show the other head at the end of the video, or I might just show it in a picture. And a normal police hat. He has been employed to make sure everybody who enters the Gotham Power Plant or Gotham Energy Facility is who they are. Now, we're going to talk about the face. The face has got some good printing, but it's very simple printing. He's looking confused, and this is an expression we've seen on many minifigures before, so I can't really talk about this much. Next, we've got the hat. The hat is just a normal police hat. You get them lots of Lego City sets, and they're just very simple design. And then we're going to be moving on to the body. The body's got very simple printing, a tie, a badge, two pockets and a belt. This is very simple printing, but it works well for this figure. It is who he is, so you can't really complain about that. That's how they usually look. And the cup of tea, very simple Lego cup. You see them quite a lot these days. And just plain black.
We have got
some belt printing that continues onto the back and a line. Just a small line up there. So that's him done. Next we're going to be moving on to Scarecrow. Scarecrow is probably the most exciting figure in this set. He's got the most printing and the most interesting printing. He's also got a very cool helmet with fire in the top. So let's start with the helmet. The helmet's just a normal pilot helmet. You see them lots. But what makes this one unique is that there's flames on the top. There's a very nice addition to this set, as he's driving a pizza lorry or a pizza bicycle. He wouldn't just be wearing his scarecrow costume, so I like how they disguised him. Next we move to the head. It's a very menacing head and there's double-sided printing. That's what it looks like on the other side. Moving down to the body, we can see there's the Luigi's Pizza logo, there's a few streaks of orange, a red line, and there's a ripped bit of his shirt there. This would be a giveaway to anybody who thinks it's just a normal taxi driver, and then they might realise it's Scarecrow. This is a very nice addition to the set because it is something realistic that could happen. So I'm very happy about that. We've got on the arms, we have got a multicolored arm. We've got yellow and brown with black hands. And then that's very, all very simple. Moving on, we've got leg printing for this figure, unlike the other figures. It is a very good leg printing, if I can zoom in. As you can see, we've sort of got a brown ripped bit, more ripped bits in his trousers, and a sort of rope coming out. Now, this is a very nice addition to this figure, seeing as he is the only one with leg printing. It makes it look different from the plain black legs that the other two figures it comes with have. And overall, this is an amazing figure. He can hold the monster pizza, which I will show you in a second when I show you the Luigi's Pizzeria truck or bicycle thing. And I will show him holding it at the end. So next we're going to be moving on to the Luigi's Pizzeria truck motorcycle thing. This is the Luigi's Pizzeria truck motorcycle thing. The bike can disconnect from the back part that contains all the pizzas. But at the moment I'm keeping it on for this review. If we turn it round at the front, see it's just a normal Lego bike, and it's got a 1x1 circular tile which is translucent orange on that side and that side, and a yellow version of that in the middle there. And then on the side they have added an extra bit onto the stud space at the end, which is the colours green and red, but in the middle it is white, which represents the Italian flag. On the sides we have a grey tile with a checkered white and red line or a sticker across it. Going above, we've got a green side and a red side, which have the Luigi's Pizzeria sign in the middle. And I'll show you the special feature for that in the middle. Up top, we've got two exclusive, well, not exclusive, but weird pizza tiles, which go on the top. And just some small rolls down the bottom. We have got a number plate which you can read as SC4R3, and a hat like a pizzeria van, a truck, motorcycle thing. It opens up to have their stock inside. So if I close that up, now it's time to show you the special features for this. At the top here, where the two pizzas are, if you turn this, the sides pop out. Now inside here is the menacing pizza and some fear gas. Now let me explain to you how this works if you're a bit confused. This is turned like that when the sides are in. And when you turn it here, the sides are pushed out as that is taking up their room. That means they fall out so you can get the contents inside. Next we're going to be looking at the Gotham power plant part for this set, or the Gotham energy facility for this set. This is the final part of the Gotham power plant, so at the end I'll be getting all of it together to make the Gotham power plant for you. This is the final part of the Gotham power plant, or as it says in there, the Gotham energy facility. So this is what we're going to call it. If you connect this part of the Gotham Energy Facility to the part in the Mr. Freeze Ice Attack set and the Joker Blue Escape set, you get the whole of the Gotham Energy Facility. The Gotham Energy Facility is in the film where all the bad guys come together to attack Batman. First, on this bit, we're going to look at the stickers. Now, these stickers are interesting because they're not just plain old logos. they are words. At the top, the first sticker is the words Gotham Energy. At the second sticker, just below it, says facility. And the third sticker, right there, says have a nice day. Now, we've got lots of detail for this set. We have got a security camera there. We've got a street lamp there. And we're going to just take a look at it in more detail. Because this has got lots of detail, I'm going to rotate it all the way around to show you everything. Here we've got a barrier that lets cars past. It can move up, down, and it can even come off as it shows from the back of the box. We've got a Lego pillar piece there and some barrier tiles there. This is a great addition to set as it really gives it the feel that you're driving into the Gotham Energy facility. Around the back you can see how the sign's attached. It's by some Technic parts and a Technic half pin. And I don't know if you can see this, but there's a little computer in there. There is a computer in all of the sets and they're just very nice additions. Going around, we have a street lamp, which is a black radar dish with a 1x1 circular translucent yellow stud. And then turning back round, we have got some 1x1 plate and 45 degree slope. And we've got four of those going across. And we have got some grill pieces up the top. These are very nice additions to the set as it makes it feel like you're actually in the Gotham power plant. Now, this is all for this set. But as I promised, I'll be putting it all together to create the Gotham Energy facility. Sorry if I called it the power plant. We're going to putting it all together to make the Gotham Energy facility with Mr. Freeze with his gun, Scarecrow with his menacing pizza, and Joker with his balloons. So I will do that now. So this is it, the Gotham Energy facility. It comes with the Scarecrow's motorcycle thing, Joker with his balloon escape, the worker with his cup of tea, Batman with his grapple gun, Batman with batarangs, Scarecrow with menacing pizza, Batman with flamethrower, worker trapped in ice, the Joker's balloon escape bomb, the Mr. Freeze ice attack, Gotham Energy facility part, and the Scarecrow's special delivery Gotham Energy facility part. If you want to build this, you will need to get the Joker Balloon Escape set, the Mr. Freeze Ice Attack set, and the Scarecrow special delivery set. I believe the Mr. Freeze Ice Attack set and the Scarecrow special delivery set are $19.99 on Amazon. However, if you have Prime, they are $15.99, and the Joker's Balloon Escape from shops is $11.99. So if you want to get them, you know what prices you need to pay. So thank you for watching the final episode of the preset reviews. I'll be back next week with not a set review but another custom machine. However, I did say I was doing the bonus episode. The bonus episode will be coming out as well as the normal episode next week.